the way it works out, mathematically, because you win at San Jose State, you're back in it. With some help from two other teams, your destiny might be in your own hands here.
It really is. You know, I told the players I told the players that scenario. I also told them that when I was in the NFL, nine things had to happen, Robert, for us to get in the playoffs, and eight of them did. And the one thing that didn't happen is, well, we forgot to win. Or we'd have been in the playoffs my second year there. So these guys have to understand, we take care of our own business, we'll see what happens, how it all falls, and stranger things have happened.
Oh, definitely. Just being in the race is fine, because, I mean, things will play out how they're supposed to play out, and all we got to do is do our part and win these next few games.
It's been a rough ride, but, you know, we're still in it. We can never quit, like Coach Shaw always tells us, don't ever quit. And we just got to do our part. Can't worry about what happens outside. We just got to take care of business, what we can do.
It's good to know that we're still at least a chance. You know, a lot of things have got to happen that are out of our control, but as long as we take care of our business, then it's always a chance. So, you know, we're a good chance to win these next two games, and we really should win the next two games. So as long as we, you know, do our job, we'll be fine.
When Coach Shaw told us, like, the way we could possibly get to the championship game is unreal. We just have to do our part and win these last two games and hope for the best, just a little extra boost and more confidence coming off a win. And we know they're struggling, but we've had struggles too, so we know what they're going through, but we just got to push through and get it done.
Down the stretch here, because they sucked it up and ended that losing streak and feeling good about themselves, you got to like where you sit right now with two games left.
Well, we do. We needed to practice well, and we practiced well today. We had a hiccup over the weekend, so we decided to take the pads off, but the kids responded very well. They're resilient, and they practice well.
Let me ask you a sensitive question here. Your future as head coach here at the University of Hawaii, have you given that any consideration?
Not really. I'm not going to quit. I'm not a quitter. I never quit anything. You can't be a coach and preach to these young people not to quit. And I can't stand coaches that quit. I was contracted to do a job. I intend to be back. But, you know, obviously there's bosses. We all have bosses. We leave it up to them. But I want to be back. I intend to be back. And we'll get this thing rolling.
How's Scott Harding feeling right now? We see him walking around.
That's a one tough son of a gun now. He took a shot. I swear that needle was that big at halftime. Right into that tender part that you and I would have cringed. And he was cringing too. They taped him up. I went like this. He said yes, and he punted the heck out of the football. He's one tough son of a gun.
He's going to be good to go, though, on Saturday.
Well, I hope. He said he did this when he was in Australia. Every week he'd be in a booth, take a shot, play. Every week he'd be in a booth, take a shot, play. So we'll see.
That sounds disgusting.
Oh, it fires you up, because they don't come any tougher than that guy now.
Real quick, UNLV, offensive or defensively, what do they pose?
Well, I know the fella. I coached with the defensive coordinator. He and I were together with the Titans and at UCLA, Timmy Houck. He's a 185-pound safety that lasted 12 years in the league, so you know he was as tough as nails. He'll play a bunch of man coverage. He'll challenge you. They did the same thing last year, and they'll get after you. They'll get after you.
Talking to these kids last week, they were saying, we're playing for pride right now. But they really weren't. If they went out and got that win, they're still mathematically alive.
How about that?
Yeah, do they have a different feel in practice this week?
We'll see. I thought we practiced well today, even though we didn't have pads on. But we'll see. I mean, they have to know that it's up to them, and then we need to get it done.
One more thing, red zone defense, with the spread offenses and tempo and everything, how important is red zone defense at college?
How about that? Robert was just telling me they were 0-for-7 inside the 25-yard line. Our special team stood up. Our defense stood up. It was fun to see. It really was. These guys, like I said so often, they deserve to have success. And they had some last Saturday. We hope it continues.
We took a picture here of your group of seniors. 22 right now. They have to mean, like, something special to you.
It really does. And I've told them so many times, you know, they were max recruits. They bought into what we were trying to get done. They've given us every amount of effort. They haven't had the success that I'm sure they wanted to have, but they're terrific. I just love those kids, and we're going to miss them a lot. As you look through that group, there's a lot of leaders on that group of 22 young men.
Yeah, absolutely. We came out today having fun because, you know, the seniors, we know that our clock is winding down, and as soon as we're done, we're done. So just want to soak it all in and have as much fun as we can.
Honestly, no, not really. It hasn't. I mean, it's all talk about senior night, like, thinking about it, it's going to be crazy, but I don't think it's going to hit me until I actually walk out there and they announce my name, saying, oh, last game in Aloha Stadium. It's going to be pretty crazy, heavy.
Yeah, it definitely has. Yeah, especially the last game at Aloha Stadium, that's tough. yeah, it's going pretty quick, so yeah, it's starting to hit me.
It's winding down. Yeah, it started hitting me last week, and then now that this is the last home game, it's going to be unreal, yeah.
Finally, what are you going to miss most about suiting up at Aloha Stadium on Saturdays?
Just pretty much going to war with the boys and just all the laughs and getting ready, preparing with the boys for the game. I'm going to miss that.
Walking down that tunnel outside the locker rooms, walking into the stadium with everyone just out there roaring and the band playing and everyone just on the field and walking out there and seeing everybody there to support, it's awesome. So I miss that a lot.
After making a play, like just the sound of the crowd, I love that. Coming off after, you know, causing a fumble on a punt or getting, pinning him on the one or something like that, it's always a good feeling. And obviously scoring a touchdown is one of the greatest feelings at home. So, yeah, I'll definitely miss that.